Hello, children of Florida. Today, I'm going to teach you one nugget of wisdom, or maybe two nuggets. And I haven't decided yet if you're going to get one or if you're going to get two. But as always, first, I require something warm to drink. Coffee, my favorite. No, I need to do that better. Coffee, my favorite. Now, before we get going, I know what all the people of Florida are dying to know is, what is the weather like here in Colorado in February? Well, let's go take a look. It's a veritable winter wonderland out here. As always, in February, it is snowing outside, but the high today will be somewhere near freezing and the low will be below freezing. It was that yesterday, it's that today, it will probably be that again tomorrow. All right, so now you got your weather, and now you're gonna need your nugget. I've decided you're getting one nugget, not two, one. It's been proven teenage brains can only hold on to one thing at a time. So you don't get multiple nuggets from your father, you get one. There's gonna be one nugget. But first, a chess lesson. This chess lesson is about pawns and the rook, this rook right here. So the pawns are on the board and the rooks are also on the board, and sorry about the sunlight shining directly at us. It's that time of day. But here we go. We know that we want to control the center of the board, right? That's these four squares right here. Ba-da. And so one of the things, a couple of general principles, is when you are capturing with pawns, you want to capture towards the center. So at the end of the game, these pawns here are kind of gone, and maybe there's one here, it gets gone, and you're left with more outside pawns on the right and left. And so the pawn that's remaining, you don't want a pawn that's in the middle necessarily remaining, because there are a lot of opportunities to capture it. Now the rooks are already here at the beginning of the game on the left and the right side of the board. So as you march this pawn forward, it's nice to have this guy, wherever he is, sitting behind this pawn, supporting it all the way to the promotion square. And so typically though, the pass pawn or the pawn that is left over, that shit is not in the way of it, so it has a clear path to the end, is an outside pawn. The A pawn, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, Alice the A pawn, or Harry the H pawn right there. So these are the pawns that you want to, at the end game, after the queens are gone, those are the pawns you want to march to the end of the board to get another queen. All right, here is your nugget. Last week, or last message, I talked about what I like to call the four pillars of respect. If you want to be respected, or know if somebody is worthy of your respect, hopefully you have some kind of principles that you hold near and dear. Mine are courage, competence, humility, and respect. Those are my four. And so you feel free to adopt or borrow those. But at some point, because you guys are getting older, it will become relevant for you to be doing something to pay the bills. You will have bills because that's part of moving out. And so you need to know, in case no other adult has told you, you need to know what a good job is. If you run a business and you hire people, this is one of the first things you tell people. And this is something, I don't know if I told you guys, but when the kids were younger, There are three things that comprise a good job. If you do these things, the chances of you ever being fired are near zero. If you're missing one of these things, that just means you're a pain in somebody's ass. And so, without further ado, here are the three components of a good job. Number one, and these components of a good job work in a school environment, they work in a business environment, they work in an employee-employer career track environment. These are the three components. If you can do these three things, you will be loved because the bar is low out there, my children. So, number one is quality work. You have to do quality work. That is simply the work that everybody wanted you to do. I had a lady clean a house one time, and I call her Nearly Clean Autumn. Her name's Autumn, but to me and my phone, she's Nearly Clean Autumn because she does some of the work, most of the work, but never all of the work. And so that was Nearly Clean Autumn. You need to do quality work. That is number one. Number two is you need to do efficient work. Baby boomers and Gen Xers and older people like to use the word sense of urgency. I don't like the word urgent because people who are urgent tend to make mistakes, but you need to be efficient. What does that mean? It means if the job should take 20 minutes and you take 3 hours, it's not efficient work. So you need to do quality work and efficient work. And then finally, number three, you need to have a good attitude, which generally means you just need to be pleasant to be around. You're in charge of your attitude. You're in charge of the effect you have on other people. Very, very important. So, I'm going to be a little bit redundant here and say if you're doing amazing work and you're very efficient, but you're a pain in the ass to be around, you are not doing a good job, and I'm looking for other people to replace you if I've hired you. If you're doing amazing work and you're a joy to be around, but it takes you all damn day to do something that takes 20 minutes, exit visas are imminent. And if you're doing amazing work and whatever the other one is, and you have a good attitude, you're doing efficient work, you're doing it fast, you got a good attitude, but you're not doing quality work, it's not up to snuff, it's not gonna work well. You really need all three things are the component of a good job. These are the things to keep your job and to not get fired, to move up in the world, whether it's a job or whether it's an entrepreneurial venture. You need wisdom, you need humility, you need competence, and you need to start growing in these things and getting better and better at these things. So humility, wisdom, competence, and whatever the other pillar of respect is. Go out and look at the other video. So there is your nugget. Well, I think that's all for today. Like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Hit it. This is your father speaking from colorful Colorado, where youth meets opportunity and you, yahoos, sadly, are viewing this from northern Florida. What was she thinking? Where old people go to die, or middle-aged people hit the wall. Love you guys. We'll talk soon.